University of Mines and Technology, one of the fastest growing universities in Ghana today, where engineering is the official lingo and excellence is the norm.
You know, our core values are knowledge, truth, and excellence. And so we try to inculcate these core values both into our staff and our students. And so the staff work very closely with the students to be able to, you know, give them the best education that they can possibly have across the whole world. And so currently, we are the best publicly funded university in the country.
1/3 of the national budget is spent on education. And I'm happy that with the investments that we make in education, one of the universities that gives us value for money on the money that we spend on tertiary education is the University of Mines and Technology. And I wish to promise you that government will continue to support this university to become the center of excellence in Africa that we want it to be.
UMaT started as the Tarkwa Technical Institute in November 1952. In 1961, through the initiative of the Ghana Chamber of Mines, TTI was reorganized to become the Tarkwa School of Mines. In 1976, the Tarkwa School of Mines was affiliated as a faculty to the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, and thus became the KNUST School of Mines. In October 2001, the KNUST School of Mines was again reorganized to become the Western University College of KNUST. It is the Western University College which was given a full-fledged autonomous university status by Act 677 in November 2004 and renamed as the University of Mines and Technology, UMaT, Tarkwa.
The aims and objectives of UMaT as an educational institution is to provide education through teaching, active research, and to also provide service by consultancy and other services for the whole community, both nationally and internationally.
The university offers programs at both the undergraduate and the postgraduate levels. Currently, we run programs in the following disciplines: geomatic engineering, geological engineering, mining engineering, mineral engineering, petroleum engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical and electronic engineering, mathematics, computer science and engineering, and now we have added environmental and safety engineering.
We pride ourselves in the fact that our graduates are all over West Africa, Africa, and indeed the whole world. Go to wherever mining is being practiced and you'll be sure to find a product from this university. Our students come from all over the world. Of course, the major intake is from the West African sub-region. We have students from Nigeria, from Cameroon, from Sierra Leone, from Equatorial Guinea, and indeed we are having students coming from Asia now. We have students from China. So it's an international environment.
We are very mindful of the quality of our products, and therefore we keep very manageable class sizes. And so if you study at UMaT, you are sure that you will have the quality.
We are about 2,000 in number compared to other universities who are 20,000, 30,000 in number. And this means the student-lecturer relationship, the student-lecturer ratio is very good and very healthy. In a day, a lecturer can have time for the whole class, the entire class, even if it's a consultation, if it's a counseling process, if it's mentorship, if it's supervision. Can have time to listen to each and every student and share what he has.
Since childhood, I've always wanted to be an engineer. simply because that has been my passion. And I chose UMaT basically because of the mission statement of the school. And this is to train world-class professionals to meet African agent needs.
There's this exposure UMaT gives you. It's like you actually get that training to be able to come out with something different.
It's an engineering school, so it's like narrowed down to everyone around you is doing the same thing with you. You can meet anyone, can walk up to anyone and ask, help me with my technical drawing or basic mech or any mathematics question.
We are number one in Ghana because in terms of practical, our students are well trained. If they go out from this university, they are out kick any time, any moment they are being called upon. Because of the practical knowledge, I can vouch for you that if other universities are competing with us in terms of practical, we are ahead of them.
UMaT students are taught to become all-round professionals and are therefore educated in the principles of economics, communication skills, and literature, among other courses that combine to better prepare them for the job market.
This is the only engineering university, for example, where we study basic French. Currently, Sciences is running a very significant program, that is Certificate in English program for students from the Francophone countries, so that to prepare them to enroll onto the science programs we have in the university.
My name is Kindo Saga Ahmed. I'm from Burkina Faso, and I'm a student of mining engineering, first year. Last year, I've been offered a 1 year certificate in English in order to improve my English.
The University of Mines and Technology has first-class laboratory, library, and computing facilities for research work in mining and related disciplines. The laboratories include geomatic laboratory, geological laboratory, soil and rock mechanics laboratory, mineral processing laboratory, mine environmental and safety laboratory, explosives laboratory, mechanical engineering laboratories and workshops, and light and heavy current laboratories. The university's ultra-modern library complex can best be described as special.
This library is unique, and it is special because most of the resources that we have you may not get in some of the other university libraries. We support departments which are also special. I mean, the departmental labs are so unique, and the library supports these areas so that the teaching, learning, research and everything is done in a serene atmosphere.
There are excellent employment opportunities for UMaT graduates, both locally and internationally, in mining and allied companies, construction and manufacturing companies, electrical and electronic companies, financial institutions, geological and survey departments, energy boards, power authorities, government and non-governmental agencies, educational and research institutions, the aviation industry, the military, petroleum industry, and ICT and allied industries.
The practical training in UMaT is, I think, the best because you get a lot of, you know, hands-on experience before you actually get to the field, which is quite different. On the academic side, very intensive and it's good. I mean, when you get into the market, you can actually see that, you know, you can easily practice what you've been taught.
Coming out of the institution, I believe I was a well-rounded person who was going to be able to adapt to various job descriptions.
Yeah, UMaT has a very bright future. We are thinking of upgrading the petroleum engineering department into a school of
petroleum studies, where we will do both upstream, midstream, and downstream courses so that we can cover all the aspects of the requirements for personnel. Secondly, we are planning to start a department of renewable energy engineering as well as civil engineering programs. So we hope that in the next 5 years, if things fall in place, UMaT should obviously be one of the best universities of the type in Africa.